Space travel takes a really long time, and as much as I love board games and asking my mom if we're there yet, hanging out and eating snacks might not be the best strategy for killing time on our way to the red planet. That's mostly because being awake for that long means we're gonna need to eat and drink and do all of those normal human things, which means bringing a lot of supplies with us, which is not super practical. But if we've learned anything from movies, the solution is to sleep our way through space. But is long-term snoozing like Ripley and Alien even possible? To tackle this space sleep conundrum, let's start with the basics. Without the assistance of sedation or fancy chambers, we have to know exactly how long humans can sleep on our own. Typically, we only sleep about 8 hours per night, and though that can vary, it's unusual for healthy adults to regularly sleep over 10 hours. But in the 1960s, two volunteers put sleep duration to the test. They were monitored as they lived isolated underground for several months. In the absence of daylight, their sleep cycles got real crazy. One guy fell asleep for 30 hours and woke up thinking it was just a short nap. 30 hours! In the following years, researchers did more organized and controlled studies. And what they found is that when isolated from light and other external markers of time, it's not that uncommon for humans to fall into longer sleep cycles. All of this could be a great natural starting point for hacking our sleep to fit our space travel needs. But it won't get us all the way there, since extended sleep periods are often followed by extended waking periods. So we're gonna need something a little more sophisticated than a dark room to get us into deep space. And luckily for future Mark Watneys out there, there are a lot of scientists trying to figure this out. And one of the most exciting projects in the works is at a company called SpaceWorks Enterprises, which is the actual name of a real company that actually exists and is great. They've been working with NASA to develop a stasis chamber that they say could keep astronauts asleep for 2 weeks at a time, maybe longer. Now, I know what you're thinking. 2 weeks, that's not enough to get me to Mars. And you're right. But SpaceWorks does have a plan for that. They suggest stacking these shorter hibernation periods back to back with a couple of days in between to walk around and stretch out. The crew can rotate waking and sleeping shifts and voila, you'll be in deep space before you even know it. First though, this design isn't for an individual sleeping pod, but a shared sleeping chamber. The chamber works by lowering a group of astronauts' body temperatures to 32 degrees Celsius. Then it sedates them to suppress the body's reaction to the cold. The low temperature puts bodies into a mild hypothermia, slowing down the metabolic rate and preventing injury from lack of oxygen. Robotic arms will then check up on the astronauts while they slumber, and any bodily waste will be, well, let's just say there are catheters involved, which all sounds a lot like hypersleep to me. Aside from greatly reducing the necessary food and water needed for the mission, these stasis chambers could also have some other major benefits, like requiring a smaller area to be thoroughly protected from radiation. The researchers also want to equip the chambers with artificial gravity, which could prevent a lot of the negative health effects associated with long-term space travel. But danger, Will Robinson! Don't try taking one of these bad boys to Proxima Centauri. We still haven't figured out how to slow down aging. So even though you wouldn't have to be entertained and fed on the 81,000-year journey, you would still be very dead by the time you got there. Sadly, these don't actually exist for us yet. So if we send astronauts to Mars in the 2030s, they'll probably just have to sleep like normal people. In the meantime, as a person who enjoys a good cold nap, I do hope they make an Earth version for this soon. Figuring out how to sleep our way to Mars is one thing, but what do we do for food once we get there? NASA's working on that now. You can check it out here. And one last thing, doctors actually already use mild hypothermic states like these to prevent brain damage after cardiac arrest, saving lives and getting us to space at the same time. Science is the best. Thanks for watching.